What people do when they're trying to work with LLMs is they go, I need to create a better output from the LLM. Really work on the human prompt. Improve what I'm saying to the LLM so that it returns a more accurate or reliable output. So I'm going to focus all my efforts on what I initially type so that I get the right answer back. But if we think back to how LLMs work, how likely is that to always succeed? If you think about what comes out of an AI, how LLMs work is that they predict the next token, let's just call it word, based upon the previous words. And how they do that is based upon the data upon which they were trained. Now, they don't have access to that data on which they were trained. What they have access to is loads of formulas which have been created from that data, all right? So they're not retrieving information, they're predicting words based upon patterns that they learned from their training data, which is pretty much all of the words on the internet. So given that, what they're actually doing when they output something is they are creating coherence. They're creating a coherent response. So what they're actually creating is what they think you want to hear. What a lot of people think they are doing or want them to be doing is outputting something that is true or accurate. If we think about this as the Venn diagram, there are some things which are coherent, which are not true or accurate. When I say true, what I mean is, let's say you've got some instructions on the internet and you ask the LLM, okay, tell me how this machine works. Yeah. What you're expecting, because this is what Google supposedly does, is it returns the actual accurate instructions to you because you can read them. They're there on the internet. That's what I mean by true. That's not what an LLM does. An LLM has been trained on those instructions, but it doesn't actually have access to them. It's inferring what the instructions are based upon all of this training data. So you can have a lot of stuff which is coherent, but which is not true or accurate. Having said that, you can also have stuff which is true and accurate, which isn't coherent, because there's a lot in the universe which isn't particularly coherent, but which is still true. So look at the political situation, for example. So there's a lot in the world which is true, stroke accurate, but which is not coherent. So an LLM output isn't wrong exactly, because some of what is coherent is true, is accurate. But some of it isn't. So when you understand what is coming out of an LLM in that way, you will not get so frustrated when it gets things blatantly wrong, because that's how they work at the moment. Okay, and I'm not saying this is going to be forever, but just at the moment, that's what specifically LLMs do. Now, AI companies are putting all kinds of other engineering around them to modify the output, to make them more true and accurate. But at this point, you've got to recognize that all an LLM can actually do is create coherence, some of which happens to be true. Based upon that understanding, traditional prompt engineering, what people do when they're trying to work with LLMs is they go, all right, I need to create a better output from the LLM. So what I need to do is really work on the human prompt. I need to improve what I'm saying to the LLM so that it returns a more accurate or reliable output, a more true output. Yeah? So I'm going to focus all my efforts on what I initially type so that I get the right answer back. But if we think back to how LLMs work and this coherence and truth thing, how likely is that to always succeed? Well, I'm not sure. I don't know. I'm not an expert. But I'm going, you know what? I'm not convinced that that's the only way. I'm not saying it's the wrong way, but it's the only way to work with these machines. So my question when I came into this was, let me just assume that an LLM is never going to be 100% accurate because it only produces a coherent output. So it's often false or inaccurate, not always, but often. If I assume that, then how could I work with this feature and not treat it as a bug to be removed? It's a very different question you're asking yourself. And this is what I came up with. I'm calling it vibe prompting after the vibe coding thing that's going on at the moment. And it's a very different way of thinking about prompting or working with an LLM. So instead of the prompt engineering approach where you just go, I'm just focusing on this to get a better that, what you actually do is you go, okay, I'm going to prompt in here and I'm going to assume that what comes out of here is inaccurate or some of it is inaccurate. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to curate the output. I'm going to use my taste and judgment in order to then put something different into my next prompt. And so this is actually much more of a process. It's not just, right, I need it to return the correct output and I'm done. It's, I need to create a system where I am using my taste and judgment to create more accurate and reliable knowledge. It's output over time. It's a process. It's not a result. It's an ongoing process of creating knowledge. And the thing is about this is it really does put the human at the center. You assume that at least some, sometimes all of what it's saying is inaccurate. Yeah, but remember, you have a brain. We have a brain. I don't understand why. I really don't understand why everyone's so, I mean, I do understand it. There's money and things, but just on a personal level, I don't want to remove my brain from the process. I actually enjoy figuring things out. I enjoy creativity. I enjoy using my mind to critically think through problems. It's actually one of the great joys of my life. I go, oh, I get it. Oh, no, that's wrong. Why is that wrong? Well, that's interesting. I'm not sure about that. What do you think about? Isn't that one of the things that makes life worth living? So why? What do we want? We just want to lie there like in Wall-E, floating around on sofas. No, that's not what we want. What we want is to be involved. What we want is to create. What we want is to put ourselves at the center of our process. And when you think of it like this, it's a really wonderful and mind-expanding process. It's almost like the LLM becomes this appendage, unreliable, but this appendage that can help you see things differently. So that is essentially where my approach comes from. And what you will notice in this approach as well is the prompts are actually much shorter than a lot of prompt engineering prompts, which can like be like sort of tomes, like essays where there's like 5,000 different things, because we are improving the output, improving our understanding. It's not even the output, it's our understanding over time through the process of working with the LLM.